up, YouTube, and welcome back to another episode of It's Food, Dude! So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how you can make some cute little sugar cookies. These sugar cookies aren't going to be your average sugar cookies because they're going to have all the funfetti sprinkles on top. Those are my favorite kind of sugar cookies. I don't know if your state is under stay-at-home orders, but Texas isn't right now. So if you are, this will help you so you don't have to, you know, go to Nestle Toll House or go to Mrs. Fields Cookies. You can make them right at home. So if you like how that sounds, let's get started with the video.
Okay, so you're going to need 2 3/4 cup of flour, 1 1/2 cups of sugar, 1 cup of butter, 1 egg, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, and also 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and some sprinkles. So I'm going to start out with my softened butter, and I'm just going to put that in a bowl. You can use a KitchenAid, but I didn't feel like washing that today, so I'm just going to use a hand mixer. Voila. To your softened butter, you're gonna slowly start to add your sugar, but you do want to make sure that you're using your hand mixer to whip that butter, and then you can add the sugar slowly, little by little. Voila. Yeah. I'm only coming out to play. Nothing more that I. So your butter should look like a pale yellow like this, and then it'll have the texture of like wet sand. And now you can add in your 1 egg. Make sure you crack your egg in a separate bowl so that you don't get any eggshells inside of your cookie dough mixture. And then just continue to blend that. And as you notice, your mixture will become more yellow. Alright, so to this mixture, I'm going to add in my baking soda, as well as my baking powder and salt. You can add these to your dry ingredients with your flour, but I just decided to go ahead and add it to my bowl. And then I'm also going to add in my 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract as well, straight to my bowl. And then we can just slowly start to incorporate our flour once we blend all of these ingredients together. So as you slowly start to incorporate all of that flour, your mixture will definitely become thicker and it will start to look like a dough, like it should look like. And so I want to show you guys what it looks like right now. So that's what it looks like right now, and the consistency is going to be a lot thicker. So we can go ahead and finish adding in the rest of our flour. And like I said before, like, this will be a lot easier if you do have a KitchenAid, but the hand mixer works just as well. So with the hand mixer, I will have to knead this dough by hand just because it's not really coming together as well as it would if I had my KitchenAid mixer. So I'm going to take about 5 minutes incorporating this dough so that it's a nice solid ball. So after kneading the dough, this is what it should look like. As you notice, it does look like a sugar cookie dough mix, and we're good to go. So we're just going to line our cookie sheet with parchment paper like we always do so our cookies don't stick. And I'm just going to measure this to my pan, and I'm going to get some scissors and cut off the excess paper. And using a tiny bowl, I'm going to add in our sprinkles. I got mine from DecoPack, but you can always get your sprinkles from the grocery store. And we're just going to put that in front of our cookie sheet because we will be actually balling up our cookie dough mixture and rolling it in the sprinkles. When you're making homemade cookies, you always want to make sure you use an ice cream scoop so that you can have equal cookie sizes. And then I'm just rolling that in my hand a little bit and then just slowly dipping one side of the cookie into the sprinkles. I'm not going to cover my entire ball with sprinkles just because the bottom's going to be brown and I don't need sugar on all sides of my cookies, just the top. So we're going to bake this in a 350 degree oven for about 8 minutes, and you just want to make sure that you're frequently checking your cookies so that you don't burn them. So my cookies just got out of the oven, and as you can see, it has that nice little crackle and they've doubled in size, so I think we've done a pretty good job.
Thanks everybody for watching. If you liked it, give it a fat thumbs up, a juicy thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel. You can comment down below. Let me know if you want me to make a specific recipe. And see you in the next one. Bye.